Hey, Lewis Turner here for Guitar Interactive magazine, back with another review. And in this one, we've got a fantastic brand new guitar from Danelectro. And here it is. So this is part of the brand new range from Danelectro models. And this is the Danelectro 64. So Danelectro are currently celebrating 60 years in the business of making fine guitars. And we've been given this one to check out. So as usual, we'll go through the different features on this particular model and see what different sounds we can get out of it. So this particular 64, as you can see looking at it, is a solid reverse double cutaway offset horn body. So we got the larger horn sitting at the bottom as opposed to the other way around. This one is finished in a fantastic three-tone sunburst finish. And there's various other things that we'll look at down here. But let's start down on the headstock. So here we have a traditional Danelectro headstock with their name and the cool little 64 sign there. The nut on this, you can see here, we've got a zero fret at the top here. The nut is nice and silky and smooth. I haven't used the trem on it. We haven't got any tuning issues. And the zero fret just enables you to, it tends to give better tuning stability down the bottom end, better intonation. And it really gives you a nice low action as well. So zero frets are more and more commonplace on higher end guitars. Let's flip it over and have a look at the back. So we've got Danelectro tuners, which are fine and doing a good job, vintage looking tuners, of keeping everything nice and in tune. And we've got a quite a cool, you don't often see this on the back of necks, the kind of same sunburst finished on the neck here, which is a nice little feature. A glossed finish. It's a nice kind of thin line neck that fits nice in the hand. Here's how the neck joint, here's how Danelectro fit it to their guitar bodies. And you can see the same sunburst finish on the back there. Really nice finish throughout, looks really cool. And you'll see when I flip it over the other way as well, we've got nice big large cutaway to get access to the higher end of the fretboard. Flipping it back round. The reason I haven't mentioned woods is actually Danelectro haven't specced what wood they actually use on this particular model. Apart from, I can tell you that the fingerboard you can obviously see is rosewood. So they had various woods in the past that they like to use, the Masonite and stuff like that. It's a pretty light guitar, so it may well still be that wood, but I wouldn't like to say for certain. It's quite hard to tell with the thick finish on it. So as I said, the 22 fret rosewood fingerboard, fairly small frets, but because we've got the zero fret there, it makes action nice across the fretboard and playability nice and easy. No sharp fret edges or anything, nice and easy to play, and the upper fret access is remarkable, actually. With this cutaway here, I can get right up to 22 in no problems whatsoever, and because we haven't got the large neck joint on the back, your thumb still has plenty of room to move around there as well. You can see a nice little detail as well, or a unique detail. We've got an offset humbucker here, and the neck, the end of the neck there has been cut in that angle as well. Onto the body then. I've already mentioned the finish on it and the shape, and we've got nice little contours around the edge which make it nice and comfortable to play. The cool thing about this that will attract a lot of people is the Bigsby, and it's a proper real Bigsby trem. It's been set up very nicely, looks the part, adds the vintage look to it. Our jack socket down here just below. I will say that for this, because of the Bigsby and dropping the Bigsby down, you're going to need like a 90 degree jack in there to move the Bigsby out of the way. Tone and volume control that I'll come back to in a second. We got on this bridge here on the saddles, we've got nice little rollers that I don't think you'll be able to pick up on the camera. But nice little rollers here that are really nice and smooth. Again, everything designed, that the zero fret and the nut, everything designed to make the action nice and smooth so we don't have any tuning stability issues. And so far it's been working really well. A vintage style dual humbucker and lipstick pickup in the bridge, and one of their own humbuckers in the neck, and a three-way switch. I'll show you, so here's what the bridge sounds like. So this is our bridge lipstick humbucker pickup. A nice nice and bright. I'm playing with a little bit of crunch just because it's the way the amp's set up. Middle. And neck gives us a nice deep tone. So on this model, we've got a cool little feature in that the tone control also acts as a tap, a coil tap, so you can split this lipstick humbucker. So if I just pull it up, and now get the single coil sound of that humbucker pickup. As opposed to that, or you might hear it more down there. And then you can bring in the rock a bit, so you could kind of, you know, if you wanted a lighter sound, you could use a single coil. So that's a cool little feature, and with a clean sound that worked really nicely, you know, for a kind of a rhythm, strummy sound. That's cool, nice little feature. I like the coil tap thing. And the other great thing actually on this particular guitar is you don't notice that much volume loss, you just notice more gain, so that's cool. The Bigsby works really nicely, which I'm going to use the coil tap here. It's really nice, smooth action, no creaking, you've only just got to touch it just a little bit, and we can do upward stuff as well. It's not, you know, you're it's not like for big whammy bar tricks, it's just those subtle kind of shimmies. That kind of thing to chords. Get a little bit of upward movement. Nice, and you can drop it down out of the way, so that's kind of cool. It's just enough reach to be able to do it on lead stuff as well. Little scoops. So as a Bigsby is intended, really, just to bring that little shimmer to as an effect. The volume control is nice and easy to reach, and we can use it. It cleans up really nicely as well. So that's cool. Let's have another little play, try some different sounds. I'll try it with it left on a split pickup this time. There we have it, the brand new Dan Electro 64, celebrating 60 years of Dan Electro guitars. Great looking, unique looking. Some people are, you know, really like it or not be that keen, but I think you all agree it's definitely unique looking. Plays beautifully, beautifully set up, and a great tone from it as well. I really enjoyed the sounds I've been able to get from these pickups and from the construction. Really nice, mellow, warm sound, really encourages a long time of playing. So yeah, if you're in the market for something a little bit different, or you're a Dan Electro fan, I definitely suggest you go and check one of these out. Thanks for watching.